Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us, it's called Portfolio Standard Deviation. Now see, Portfolio Standard Deviation, it measures the expected variability in the rate of return of the portfolio, and it is determined based on the standard deviation of the return of each asset in the portfolio. Well, this is just a dialog box that's written, but we'll try and get incorporated with the whole concept in a very detailed format. So, portfolio standard deviation. Now, see, portfolio standard deviation is the standard deviation of the rate of return on the investment portfolio and is used to measure the inherent volatility of an investment. So, it measures the investment risks. Okay. And it helps the analyzing the stability of the return of the portfolio. So portfolio standard deviation is calculated based on the standard deviation of the return of each asset in the portfolio. So the proportion of the each asset in the overall portfolio, that is the respective weights in the total portfolio, and also the correlation between each pair of the asset in the portfolio. Let's do some interpretation part of the standard deviation of the portfolio. See, this helps in determining the risk of the investment. That is what we call as the expected returns. So a high portfolio standard deviation highlights that, you know, the portfolio risk is high, and return is more volatile in nature, as such, you know, the unstable as well. So a portfolio with a low standard deviation, the low SD, the portfolio with the low standard deviation implies that, you know, less volatility and more stability in terms of the returns of the portfolio, and it is very useful financial metric when comparing different portfolios. We'll go with an example part to get more insight. See, let's say there's a guy called John. John had planned to invest a certain amount of money. Let's say John plans to invest a certain amount of money every month in one of the two funds which he has shortlisted for the investment purpose. Drop down some particular details. Let's say the average return for last 3 years, fund A and fund B. Over here, it comes down to 12%. Over here, 12%. And the standard deviation as 8, 14. So assuming the stability of the return is the most important for John while making the investment and keeping one or the other factors as constant, we can easily see that both the funds are having in the average rate of return closely standing at 12%. Okay, so, you know, fund A has a standard deviation of, let's say, 8, the SD standing at 8, which means its average return can vary between 4% to 28%. Right, by adding and subtracting 8 from the average return. On the other hand, let's say fund B, if you see here, a standard deviation of 14, which means that a return can vary between -2 to 26% by adding and subtracting 14 from the average return. If you minus here from 14, that is, you know, you need to deduct that way. So thus, based on his risk appetite, if John wishes to avoid excess volatility, he will prefer investment in fund A compared to fund B, as it offers, you know, the same average return with a less amount of volatility and more stability on the returns part. You see 12, but, you know, SD is less, SD is more here. So the standard deviation of the portfolio is important, as it helps, you know, analyzing the contribution of individual assets to the portfolio standard deviation, and is impacted by the correlation with other assets in the portfolio and its proportion of the weight in the portfolio. Okay, now, how to calculate the portfolio standard deviation? Okay, we'll try and understand this. First, we'll try and note down some things. You know, portfolio standard deviation calculation, you know, it's a multi-step process and involves the, like, you know, the formula basically. So assuming that, you know, the portfolio comprises of two assets only, the standard deviation of the two asset portfolio can be computed using the portfolio standard deviation formula. Let me show you that. This is the formula that you can use, the standard deviation of the portfolio. There's a weight into standard deviation of A, then weight into standard deviation, that is multiplication of B, plus 2 into weight of A into weight of B into either you can multiply covariance over here or correlation into, this is the covariance of A and B into standard deviation of A into standard deviation of B. So find the standard deviation of each of the portfolio, find the weight of the each portfolio which we require here, okay, and weight of the each asset in the overall portfolio, and they find the correlation between them, that is over here, okay, correlation of the assets in the above case, between the assets in the portfolio, and correlation can vary between minus 1 to plus 1. So apply the values in the above mentioned to derive the standard deviation formula of the two asset portfolio. So let's understand the portfolio standard deviation calculation of the three portfolio, of the three asset portfolio, with the help of an example. Now calculating the portfolio standard deviation of the three asset portfolio will go something. Now this multi-step process, how does exactly it works? We'll try and understand this in a very detailed format. Over here, there are three stocks, Flame, this is Flame International. Okay, is considering, you know, a portfolio comprising of three stocks, let's say A, B and C. And this is the brief detail of weights, how they are going to invest, the expected return they are expecting, and the standard deviation, the correlation between A and B, A and C and B and C is available with us. So now for a three asset portfolio, this can be computed by weight of A into standard deviation of A, weight of B into standard deviation of B, weight of C into standard deviation of C, plus it remains the same, 2 into W into WB into covariance, this is covariance of A and B into standard deviation of A and B, plus 2 into WA into C here, the second one, into the correlation of A and C, that is 0.3, multiply by standard deviation of A and C. And then it goes with the B and C, that is weight of B, weight of C, plus, sorry, you multiply that with the correlation, 0.-15, and then the standard deviation of B and C, that is 13% and 15%. So this is how you are going to compute your entire value, where you, over here, WA, again, I repeat, and WB, WC are the weights of stock ABC, respectively, in the portfolio. This KA, KB, and KC are the standard deviation, that is, you know, sigma over here of ABC. And this RKA and KC are the correlation, sorry, not the covariance, correlation between stock A and stock B, and A and C and B and C, respectively. Okay, so if you compute over here the whole, it should come closely around 15 to 18% from the number it looks like. So we see that, you know, standard deviation of portfolio is closely around 15 to 18%, despite, you know, the individual asset in the portfolio, there is having different level of standard deviation, that is stock A 24, stock B 18, and stock C 15%, due to the correlation between them in the portfolio. So after taking the example, I want to finally conclude on this particular topic. See, standard deviation of portfolio is important tool, undoubtedly, which helps in matching the risk. Helps in matching the risk level of the portfolio with clients' risk appetite. And it measures the total risk in the portfolio, comprising of both systematic and unsystematic risk. Now, a larger standard deviation implies that, you know, more volatility and more dispersion in the returns, and thus, you know, more risky in the nature. So it helps in measuring the what we call as consistency in which returns are generated, and is a very good measure to analyze the performance of the mutual fund and also the hedge funds returns consistent. However, you know, it is persistent, you know, to note that, you know, the standard deviation is based out of the historic data and past results, may be a predictor for the future results, but they may also change over time, and therefore, you know, it can alter the standard deviation. So one should be more careful before making any investment decisions based on the same. So that's it for this particular topic. After discussing all the data regarding meaning, interpretation, a short example, we had gone a stepwise calculation of two standard deviation and three stocks, that is two stocks and three stocks calculation.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.